I'm Elise Canosa, and I am a visiting researcher at the Swedish National Heritage Board. In this video, I will be discussing activated charcoal and how it can be used to reduce pollutants in cultural heritage environments. Activated charcoal can be made from wood, peat, coconut shell, fruit pits, or coal, and it's produced by heating these materials up to very high temperatures under an inert atmosphere. This makes activated charcoal a very porous material and gives it a very high surface area. Activated charcoal is known as an adsorbent and works by adsorption, which means that it collects gas molecules from the air on its surface. This includes the surfaces of available pores. Because activated charcoal is such a porous material, it is quite efficient at capturing gas molecules on its surface, and therefore it's quite often used in air filtration devices to help improve air quality. Activated charcoal is known as a general adsorbent, which means that it can adsorb a wide range of molecules from the air. This is due in part to its wide range of available pore sizes. Additionally, unlike other adsorbents, such as silica gel, activated charcoal does not adsorb large amounts of water at low and moderate relative humidity. Pure activated charcoal is charcoal that has not been chemically treated during processing. It's known as a physical adsorbent because gas molecules adhere to its surface by weak physical forces. Activated charcoal can also be chemically treated, and this is done to help improve its ability to adsorb certain types of molecules, for example, acidic gases like acetic acid or formic acid. In this case, it's known as a chemical adsorbent or a chemisorbent, and gas molecules from the air adhere to its surface by stronger chemical bonds. Activated charcoal can come in many different forms, for example, loose pellets, granules, or powder. These can be placed inside a breathable pouch for easier handling. It can also be incorporated into materials like textiles, foam, and paint. Eventually, activated charcoal will become saturated and will no longer be able to adsorb molecules from the air. The great thing about pure activated charcoal is that it can be regenerated in these cases. This is because molecules are adhered to the surface by only weak forces. So the gas molecules can be removed by heating the charcoal up to very high temperatures under an inert atmosphere and can be used again. Chemically treated activated charcoal cannot be regenerated without losing its chemical adsorption properties. Additionally, only materials like pellets or granules can be regenerated. Materials that have charcoal incorporated into them, like textiles or foams, cannot be regenerated. In cultural heritage contexts, activated charcoal can be used actively or passively. If it's being used in an air filter, for example, in an HVAC system or in a portable air filtration device, it's being used actively because air is being forced through the charcoal. In these cases, it's most commonly used in large spaces, such as galleries or storage rooms. Charcoal can also be used in spaces with very low airflow, for example, inside display cases or inside storage boxes. In this case, air is not being forced through the charcoal and it's only working passively. In these passive situations, activated charcoal pellets or granules can be placed on a tray. They can also be placed inside a breathable pouch for easier handling. Additionally, materials like textiles and foams can be cut to size and made to fit inside the appropriate container. In display cases, activated charcoal can be placed inside hidden compartments in the display case. These compartments contain openings to the display case area to allow for airflow between the charcoal and the display case air. A small fan can also be incorporated to help increase airflow. Finally, activated charcoal can produce dust. It is therefore not recommended to be used in direct contact with collection objects or in the close vicinity of objects that have tacky surfaces. Large amounts of dust can be a health risk, but only small amounts of activated charcoal are used in cultural heritage environments, so in this way, it does not pose a health risk. Some types of chemically treated activated charcoal may require gloves for handling to reduce skin contact, but it's necessary to discuss this with your activated charcoal provider. So thanks for watching. If you need any more information about activated charcoal, please feel free to visit our website.